What are you drinking, Steven?
Oh, it's a new I Shoot Raw beverage. It's a flavored beer. It's really good.
Is it tasty?
It's pretty tasty.
Nice.
It shoots raw.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
It's unfiltered.
It is?
Mm-hmm.
Is it tasty?
Yes.
There's no getting drunk on the show, Steven.
No, I'm not getting drunk.
I've got lemonade.
Anything in that lemonade?
There's some vodka.
Some vodka?
Vodka. Jared Polin, FroKnowsPhoto. .com. And welcome to Raw Talk episode number 59. This is it's a little different because Steven and I wanted to record it. Actually, I wanted to record at night just to try to do something different. Why not? We can. Because I was figuring sometimes we're rushed during the day. We've got 8 million things going on. We're getting interrupted all the time. And I just figured that we should, I don't know, why not try something different? So it's about 9:45 here on a Tuesday, and we're sitting down to record. That's why he's got himself an I Shoot Raw beverage. We went to dinner before. I've got myself a vodka and lemonade right here, and we are going to talk about the photo show that we went up to in New York City last week. I was up on Thursday with Steven recording, and then I came home for Friday. I came home Thursday night and went back up Saturday, went to a party. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the show. We've got an Ink magazine discussion, something that I'm trying to change in my life. I'll talk about that in a minute. We've got your impressions of Photo Plus. We have some shout outs to some listeners. We have the gear of the week for the color checker, which you're going to talk about because mm-hmm. you've used it before.
It's great.
And other than that, we've got some flying solo questions about Photo Plus, and we can't forget about the PPE video, the video
yes.
that we shot. How long do you think that's going to be?
Well, it's going to be it's a total guess right now, but I'm going to say probably 20 to 30 minutes.
I hope there's that much.
We shot a lot of footage. It's the amount of cutting and editing to see what it comes down to.
Right. So what we did is we recorded from different booths on the floor, literally laying on the floor, working out in the think tank department.
Oh, yeah.
There was a lot going on.
I forgot about that part.
My whole thing is not to do a typical recording at these things. We see what other people do, and it's always in the booth, and it's like, today I'm here with John Smith.
Reviewing this gear.
Yes, we're very proud to announce to you, for the first time ever, this point-and-shoot camera that is 27 megapixels, and it does this, and it's like, I don't care. We could read the specs online all we want. And you heard me say this to some people, though. I'm like, don't sales pitch me.
Yeah.
Just have a conversation.
Be real.
All we want is a conversation, and that's what we ended up doing. So you're going to see that at the very end. We'll let you know, and after that, we'll come back to wrap up the rest of the show. But it's going to be a cool video. I can't wait to see what you end up doing when you edit it and
I can't
cut
wait
it
to
up.
See it either.
Well, yeah.
I haven't done it completely yet, but yeah, it's about halfway done.
You've seen some of it. Is it really halfway done, or are you just bullshitting?
No, it's about halfway done.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Uh-huh.
I haven't. That's why I don't know the exact time yet.
Oh, all right.
But I would say the footage looks great. The exposure, which I'm pretty surprised about, is pretty spot on, and we were totally guessing it half the time.
Well, you were guessing it.
I was guessing it, yeah. And I was flying the entire time with my shoulder rig following you pretty much.
Yeah, you had the Zacuto on the back.
Yep.
We had an interesting rig setup, and this is something different than I've had before. In the years prior, I've done it myself. I've set up the tripod so it wasn't moving. It was like a 14-millimeter lens. I had a microphone, so there wasn't much I could do, so I really appreciated the fact that you could do what you do, which is I don't have to worry about exposure with you because you know how to shoot, you know, your exposures. I don't have to worry about audio with you because you understand audio, and I don't have to worry about focus, at least I hope, because your focus should be pretty darn
yeah, we had to follow focus the entire time, so when I'm following you pretty much, I'm hoping that I'm about 5 feet away from you most of the time, but if not, I had the follow focus rig set up too. So
well, that's the joy I have with having you up there is that you know what you're doing, and it's just one less thing for me to worry about. I mean, you know how bad I am already with resetting the cameras and everything, but I don't question anything you were doing when you go to shoot up there, because I know that's what you know what you're doing.
The only issues that I had were the Nikon booth, for example, was extremely lit up versus every other booth. So every time we came in there, I had to drop the ISO a ton, probably half.
Well,
and on top of that, every other booth, like, it wasn't just a natural lighting setting. Like, every booth was different. So that was one thing we had to worry about.
Yeah, and the Nikon booth kind of had, like, spotlights and then holes and then
exactly.
spotlights and holes.
dropped every 5 feet.
It is a terrible booth, in my opinion. one of the worst Nikon booths I've ever been in. I don't understand. We're going to get
repping their colors today.
What was that?
You're repping their colors
today.
Yeah,
I got it. I know. But the one thing I didn't understand is we're going to talk, I guess we'll talk about it for now, for the minute.
Yeah.
Their booth, the way it's set up, they're usually the first booth that you see when you walk in.
Which actually, they
were. If you go in the one door, it's an Nikon. If you go in the other door, it's Canon. And smack dab in the middle now is Sony. So Sony's booth just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
I was
going to
say, they might have had more floor space than both.
And 1 year, the first year that Sony was there, or that I remember, they had a half pipe in there.
Interesting.
They had skateboarders and bike guys up there the whole time doing stuff.
That's pretty rad. Yeah, I would just sit there and watch that the whole time.
Oh, yeah, that was great. That was really cool seeing them do that. But anyway, the Nikon booth was terrible. I was told that they didn't really have booth babes this year. I mean, they did have a girl bouncing around in a blue shirt, if you remember her dancing.
Yeah, well, they too. But she was the main act, I guess. But then they would like collaborate and do.
Right.
There was like, a guy, too.
They were hidden away. They were like doing video. It was a video part. But then the part that they used to have with the girls and dancers and stuff was now a candy land, basically. It was just fake candy just because it's vibrant colors. And it was just boring. You need to have people.
And that's the other thing with the exposure that I was talking about with the Nikon booth. The Candyland booth was probably like 2 or 3 stops hotter than the everything else in that Nikon area. So when we went to talk about the candy, I had to pretty much stop recording and reset everything.
All right, we're going to get into Photo Plus when we come back to it. I want to talk about Ink Magazine. There's basically, I have this thing where I work a lot. Right, Steve?
You do?
Yes.
Didn't know that.
I get this so into such work mode that I don't leave the place, the loft. I'm always working. I feel like I need to do more. I need to do more because if I don't do more, then something's going to happen. And if something happens, then I need to do more work. And I'm like, ah. So I'm trying to get into this habit of leaving. Going to the coffee shop, which is like 3 blocks away. And I don't drink coffee, but I'll drink tea. So I'll drink tea.
I love my coffee.
Go there, drink tea. I took some of my magazines today. This was the first time I did it. And it was really great to go there and focus. Leave my phone in my pocket. I don't have any distractions.
Get away for an hour.
Yeah, it was an hour and a half, and I read my Ink magazine. This one has Gary Vaynerchuk on the cover. It's really good. It says, knowing how, 29 skills every founder needs to master. And I love Ink magazine. It's just there's nothing better than reading from people that have either been successful or who have failed and then turn those failures into success, and you can learn from them. So I do recommend anybody out there, if you have your own business, which a lot of photographers do, that you pick up things to read. I don't read enough. And every time I read something and I enjoy it, I feel inspired.
Yeah.
And I need to do more of it. But sitting in my loft and trying to read isn't going to work because I know that the distractions are right there. If I leave the place and go somewhere, I can sit there and I can just concentrate. And I felt great. And I had a lot of different ideas that came up. And those ideas stemmed from reading what was in this magazine. And I really suggest you guys go out. And I'm not just saying this because I know Gary. I'm just saying it because it's great to read this stuff and hear from people that are successful. Just one thing in here that I wanted to read out to you that Gary wrote, one of the things it says, how to do spec work and feel good about it. So I got to get it really close because I'm blind.
With
it
your says, glasses on.
Well, my glasses are on, but my magnifying glasses aren't on. They're in the other room. I have those. Those
your 9-year-old glasses?
Those are the reading glasses. So it says, the New York Jets came to me in 2009, just as I started VaynerMedia. Because they wanted to sell me a skybox in the stadium for Wine Library, which is his store. I told them, forget about the skybox. Forget about the skybox. The Jets need to be at the forefront of social media. They were unsure about hiring me, so I said, give me one player's Twitter account, and I'll show you what I can do for free. I knew it was my cost of entry. Working with the Jets is how I was able to land the Nets and the NHL as clients too.
Wow.
People overthink spec work. They get too philosophical and romantic about it. I'm not romantic about anything in business. Don't be crippled by the philosophy. Aim for the biggest possible client you can get and treat it as if it is the highest paying client of all time. If in the end they try to take advantage of you and get more work for free, remember, you can fire them as easy as they can fire you. The reason you're doing all this good, the reason you're doing all this is to get other clients, period. Now, what that's saying, it's talking about spec work. Yeah. We've all done it. We've all been told that, hey, or we've all said, you know what, give me a shot. And somebody's going to give you that shot. And if they try to take advantage of you later on, then that's not a good thing. You can walk away. But sometimes to get those major jobs, you just need to ask for it. You need to tell them that, look, I can do this. Let me prove it to you. And a lot of what we do comes down to proving our worth.
Give them a trial run, yeah.
Yeah, it's like, you know what? What's the worst that could happen? You see what I've done with my own business? Allow me to do it for you. And if I fail, I fail. No skin off your back or whatever. And if you like it, then you hire me. And that's how he did. He ended up getting the Jets, the Nets, the NHL, and I'm sure a bunch of other clients that came out of it. So That's one thing.
Yeah.
You know, and reading these magazines, I get Entrepreneur, I get Inc., and I get Wired. All tech magazines, all things that I'm interested in, and I never read them. They sit here on the sofas. The Playboys are in the bathroom.
I was going to say mine are in the bathroom.
You know, but I never read them in there either because I'm always.
Magazines,
well, yeah. I sit there and I look at Instagram or something. You know, it's like, oh, Instagram.
I know, with the phone, you don't really need them anymore.
Right. But I also have Ink on the iPad, but I rather read it in the magazine.
Yeah.
Because their iPad version isn't something that's like I could zoom in on it and I can't do much with it.
I'm a sucker for the physical, tangible product myself.
Yeah. So recommendation out there, and this is what's starting to work for me even after one day, is just to get out of your element, go focus on reading, and that's what's helped me. So I started to read this and I really enjoyed what's going on in it because I never get a chance to do it and it gave me a lot of ideas.
Cool.
So we've got that. So, Steven, you got to Photo Plus. It was your first time there.
It was.
I've been there many, many, many times at this point. What did you think?
I thought it was good. I thought it was really cool. I mean, I didn't really get to personally like walk around and check out each individual booth because we were constantly filming or doing something. But I thought it was a really cool experience. And then seeing some of the people that we work with, getting to meet them one-on-one, that was a cool thing too. And the live photo shoots and the seminars they have, everything along those points. Just to be with photographers, people that you can just relate to in the same room was a cool thing.
I think these seminars are great for people that have never been there before.
Yeah.
We didn't go to any of the seminars. We didn't go. We just went to the floor. We went to the expo floor.
Yep.
We didn't listen to anybody speak, which if we had time to do it, it probably would have been good. I think they sell that stuff for like $500. I don't know that it's
really
worth that. I don't know that that's for like an all access. I don't know that that's worth it. And I don't give a shit if they listen and say that I shouldn't say that because I'm not beholden to them at all. That's a lot of freaking money to sit in a room and listen to somebody speak.
That
especially
is a lot of money.
When you can find a lot of people's speeches online. Sure, it's great to go there and meet or be in room and hear it. If you can get your way either to sneak in the one or you can find a pass or buy a pass for maybe $100. Like if it was $100 and you could go listen to people speak, all right, I can see that. And then you get into the expo floor. The expo floor is free. You sign up for free, you can go. And it's if you sign up before a certain date. You and I went as press, which was cool. We get to hang out with other people that we know. How are we doing on time?
Good.
Yeah?
We got some free coffee, too. We got some donuts upstairs.
The food up there sucks.
Yeah,
they never supply you with good food.
But the cool thing was, too, all the free goodies. All the free giveaways and stuff that you could get on the floor and both being as
press. Well, what did you get on the floor that was a free goodie?
Well, I just saw stuff on the floor.
Like what?
I couldn't pick up anything because I was carrying everything.
I know that Kodak, for some reason, was there. They give out film.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just browsing and stuff and seeing people with all the Nikon bags, which that's a great part on Nikon to have those bags.
They do
and
it
with
every
them
year.
Switching the lanyards out too.
Yeah, they switch the lanyard. Basically, I think Sony pays for the lanyards,
and then
if you want to trade your other lanyard,
which everyone did,
then Nikon gives you their lanyard
because they saw this giant line when you first walk in. They're like, oh, I guess we got to step in that line, and you get basically switch out the lanyard with a Nikon branded lanyard.
And then you realize, why did I just wait in this line just to do this?
Yep, pretty much. And I think you got some other little giveaway, too, that wasn't worth anything.
Yeah, no, somebody asked this question, I think, in the Flying Solo about what are the goodies that they give out. And it's not the same as when you go to other conventions, like a medical convention or a dildo convention. I don't know why dildos on the brain. I don't know, but I was just thinking about AVN.
AVN?
Yeah, the Adult Video Network, Video Super Show. It's always after CES.
Yeah.
So if you go to CES,
you could just wait around for AVN.
Then you can go to the AVN Awards and Expo, where they have a lot of things. I still want
a lot of. I'm sure they have babe booths there.
They do.
Or booth babes there. I mean.
Babe. Did you say babe booths?
Yeah.
Come on, Steven.
Booth. It's the I Shoot Raw beverage.
Yeah. It's
how high much, in ABV.
How much percent alcohol is in that?
I don't know.
29,000%.
I think so.
But
it's a good buy.
I hope to go out to one of. I should go out to that show because, you know, I'm kind of jaded anymore. I've been to a lot of these photo shows. I've been to the one in Germany, which is the largest one in the world. I haven't been to the one in Japan. That would be very, very interesting to go to the one in Japan. I've been to CES, which is in Vegas. I've done that twice. And I'm kind of losing it because it's the same stuff year after year. I don't really think there was anything at this show this year that was spectacular.
Well, I mean, I enjoyed it being a first timer, but I could see why you wanted to kind of get out of there the first day.
Why don't you go reset the stuff? I'll keep talking. The first time thing is good. I think that it's great for if you've never been to a conference or a show like this, that as a beginner, you would really dig it. You'd really love going and being around other photographers, seeing all the gear that you can only see and never get to hold. That part of the aspect of it is great. When you can do that, there's nothing better than being able to hold on to a lens. You know, you can use a 600 f4. You can use the D4 just sitting up there in Nikon's booth and just rack off a million shots if you want. You could use the Sony. We used the, what was it? It was a 500 f4 when I was talking like that guy.
You're zooming in on that guy.
I was doing the bad lip reading. Yeah, bad lip reading or what? Hello, I bet you can.
That'll be in the video too.
Yeah, so that will be in the video. But you get to touch things that you don't normally get to touch. We're not talking about the AVN awards anymore. But that's the photo show. So if you ever get a chance to go to one of them, I think you would enjoy it. I'm just jaded at this point. But the one thing that I love doing at these shows is meeting you guys, meeting the Fro readers. We run into so many different people on the floor. And this has happened.
Yes, we did.
How far?
We literally stopped like every 5 feet. Like we would get to a point and we were about to do like an interview with one of the booth babes or something like that. And every 5 seconds it was like, hey, Jared, can I get a picture? Can I do this? Which is totally cool and understandable. But it's like we barely got stuff done as far as filming because it was constant stopping,
yeah, but
which is awesome.
It's great. And
it's really great.
I don't not say hello. We take the time, whatever we need.
We would be in the middle of an interview and you would stop and do it.
Well, would we?
I guarantee you would.
But I don't think people really interrupted interviews.
No, they
would wait
didn't.
Till the end.
But you could tell who was like kind of waiting around.
Well, you can see them out of the side of your eye, people trying to take pictures.
Yeah.
The thing is, you get these people that walk around. I don't know if they're readers or not. And they'll stand right next to you
and take a picture
and then walk away.
Yeah.
It's like, what are you doing?
It's like, we just saw you. You could just say hi, dude. Just come up and say hi.
Just say hi. And there was one girl that saw me on Saturday. She came over and she started to cry.
That's crazy.
I'm like, why are you crying? Don't cry.
Was she like bawling crying?
She was like, she just saw Jared Leto or something.
Maybe you changed your life. Who knows?
Did she tell you the story? She didn't tell me a story. She just was like, I've watched you and I like you so much. And she just,
you're Jared Leto, right?
Yeah, I'm Jared Leto. Wait, come on. Give me a song.
This
give me
is
a song.
30 Seconds to Mars
give me
concert,
a song.
Right?
Give me a song.
The Kill, The How, City of Angels.
The City of Angels. That's all I got out of that.
Attack.
I don't know their song.
I forget how it goes. The Kill is the big one. That's like their first single that they really hit it off with.
I don't remember.
But for some reason, this I Shoot Raw beverage is not making me remember.
Come on, Steven. Stay on task here. But we have a very diverse fan base.
Yes.
Which was very evident. And Steven debated me talking about it. Well, anyway, we have a lot of African-American readers. I'm not shying away from the fact that that is freaking awesome.
It is.
All right? A very diverse group that when we were at Photo Plus, we had so many of our African-American readers stop by and say hello.
I would say about 75%.
I would agree that it was about 75%.
I don't know Saturday. I wasn't there for Saturday.
It was basically 50-50.
Yeah.
And it's great. I mean, you don't know who your readers are until you see them. I am the least racist person in the world. Like
you and me both.
I don't care. Like nobody cares.
It's 2013.
It's 2013. Nobody cares. Oh, I'm not even going to get into that other subject, but nobody cares anymore. It's like we're all people. And in 40 years, everybody's going to be a mix of everybody else, which is the best thing that could ever happen, because then hopefully racism is gone at that point.
Yep.
When everything mixes, it's like awesome.
It's going to be a big melting pot.
Well, finally.
Which is already almost there.
Well, we're there, but it's just like, Who cares? I don't care.
It's the relatives and the you know, all those older generation.
But anyway, I almost forgot. It's Lil's birthday tomorrow, which is Wednesday
the
30th.
How old is she?
Lil's going to be 103.
Oh, my.
But I want to come back to this. If you are a...
103.
I have a new hashtag, and I'm just going to say it. If you're a black listener, hashtag... I wrote this down. I didn't want to mess this up. I wrote it down, Stephen. Where is it? Yes. Black listener. Hashtag black listener at FroKnowsPhoto. I want to know. There is nothing wrong with this. Hashtag black listener at FroKnowsPhoto. I'd love to hear from you guys. Represent strongly. And that is what I have to say on that part. But it was great meeting everybody.
It was. And everyone was super nice. Very nice people and very approachable.
Yep. Getting photos, talking about stuff. I had to fly. There's a guy. It comes up in the flying solo. We have his question. He was cool. Yeah. I didn't understand a word he said because I think he's Scottish.
At the show, you mean?
Yeah.
But you can understand, I guess, what he wrote.
Read it here. I don't remember. I think he's Scottish. I got every other word.
Yeah.
But anyway, Lil's going to be 103, or by the time this comes out, she'll already be 103 as long as she's still alive and kicking.
I'm sure
she doesn't
will.
Die on her birthday, which, whatever. At this point, she's 103. You can't get angry.
She's lived her life.
It's one of those things, like, you celebrate people's lives at this point when you get to 103. I mean, when you get to 90, for God's sake, it's like that. But now she's going to be 103, so we have three candles. I'm just going to tell her. I'll be like, Lil, every year you have a new birthday, we have to buy an extra candle. We can't just buy two
candle
numbers.
We can't afford it anymore, Lil. Yeah. We're going to have 120 candles soon.
We don't do it. We just do three numbers.
Oh, okay.
So we have to have a 1, a 0, and a 3. So we'll probably put 301 on the cake and see what she says. Last year we said she was 210.
Oh, man.
And people at her place were like, she's 210?
That's a record.
That's unbelievable. She looks great for her age.
I was watching Green Mile last night, and I think the one guy, doesn't he live till like 130 or 20 or something?
He was older, and Mr. Jang, and he goes, if Mr. Jangles is still living.
Mr. Jingles or whatever?
Jangles.
Is it Jangles?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then how much longer can I live?
Yeah, if a mouse can live that long.
How long am I going to live?
And he was already like 120 or 30.
He was just up there. What a fantastic movie,
The
Green Mile is.
Best movies ever.
I had to like try not to cry at the theater, but it was such a sad movie. I'd cry now.
And every time you rewatch it, when what's his name dies,
Michael Clark Duncan?
Yeah.
Spoilers?
He actually
did die.
Yeah.
But I blame that on Omarosa.
Yeah.
Do you know who she is?
No.
That was his girlfriend. She was from the... Anyway, I think people would know her if they watched a Apprentice.
Yeah.
Yeah, she
was... Was she on it?
Yeah, she was on. She was the bitch.
Oh, wait. I do know who that is. Wasn't she like the first season or second season?
It was probably the first or second season at the time.
Yeah.
She was a racist.
Was she?
If you really want to talk... Well, to sidestep here, a girl said this. A white girl said to her, that's the pot calling the kettle black. Okay, that is a term.
Pretty common slogan.
And she goes, what'd you say about black? And she's like, what are you talking about? That is the least racist thing in the world. It stopped. Anyway, we don't want to go down there. But that's her.
Yeah.
So it's very sucky. Do you know what his job was? Do you know what he was before he became
an actor?
An actor?
No.
He was a ditch digger.
Really?
And he would constantly...
Well, he looks big enough to do it.
He would constantly talk about how he would one day...
Wait, like a grave digger?
No,
or?
Ditch digger. Side of the road ditch digger.
Oh, okay.
And how one day he thought he could be an actor. And
well,
he did.
He
went and he became
did.
An actor.
Good for him.
All right, so that was your first time there.
Was
Boom.
My first time. Good
Ink
time.
Magazine, we covered that. We could thank Alan's Camera while we're at it. Want to thank Alan's Camera. Check out alanscamera.com. You can pick up all of your Nikon gear. They have your new Nikon D610. They have the Nikon D5300. That 58 1.4 is going to come into stock. And the new underwater camera, they have that there. So anything that you need Nikon related, go to alanscamera.com or give them a call at 215-547-2841. Ask for Brandon, ask for Alan, ask for Marlena, or ask for Rob. They will all help you out and ask for the Fro price. All right, so at Photo Plus, I went back up Saturday. You know what happens to me. I was going to stay over Friday,
I knew
Thursday
you were
going to
go back. I knew it.
I had a hotel room for Thursday night, and when we got there, I lost my steam, my momentum. I lost it,
Which usually happens halfway through the day.
Well, I get excited. I get all up, and then when I crash.
Yeah, it's like you drink a Red Bull or something. You're all like on a high, and then you just crash like midway.
It's all natural, though.
Yeah.
Because I don't drink coffee. You saw what I ate that day?
Yeah, it is all natural.
What did I have? I had a
protein bar or something, right?
It's not even a protein bar. It's just a Natural Valley peanut butter bar of some sort. That has 4 grams of protein. So I had that, and I was all raring and ready to go. And then every time I get to one of these shows, it's like, what am I going to do now? I want to do something different than what I've done before. So it's just a matter of always figuring that stuff out.
I think we filmed some good stuff.
Yeah, though. Yeah. It was good having you there to help me out and force me to make stuff happen, because that's always important. But the reason I went back up on...
Because you were supposed to stay all, till Saturday, correct?
Well, no, I was only going to stay till Friday.
But then you were debating on staying till Saturday.
I was debating. Almost had a second night of hotel room, which is way too expensive, waste of money. So anyway, I canceled my hotel room. You and I came back Thursday night late, and I decided to go back up Saturday afternoon. So I went back up Saturday afternoon, just walked around, met some people. And basically, I went up to go to the Peter Hurley F-Stoppers party.
Cool.
I went last year. It was fun. I went this year. It was fun. Also, at Photo Plus, before we get to the party, a bunch of the Antonelli kids were there. Sam Green, Steven Sutter. He doesn't go to Antonelli, but Sam Green does. And a couple of the other of them. And I took them out to dinner before the Peter Hurley party. So we went out there. They came home. I went to the party. And it was great. I got to see Mark Wallace and Peter and Zach Arias, and a bunch of readers were there.
Could anyone go to that party, or was that like an exclusive?
This year they were charging $20. I think
it's
next year.
Not terrible.
No, it's not terrible for pizza and all you can drink if you really wanted to. I just think next year, back to the basics, Peter's place. Don't spend any money on the location. I know that cost them some money because they did it near the High Line, so they rented out a place, and that's why they were collecting money. I just think they should get sponsors and just take sponsors' money and let them pay for the whole thing.
Surprised they didn't.
Yeah, I don't know why, but maybe they will next year. It's always the best party to go to during the Photo Plus. If you really want to meet, you know, Mark Wallace and Zach and Peter and all the F-Stoppers people and a lot of other people that come out, and I'm usually there, then it's definitely worth it to just show up and hang out. It's one of the times that you can meet a lot of us.
And I've met all of them for the first time this past, when we were at PPE, and they're all great people. They're all very, very friendly and very approachable and very nice.
Oh, yeah. So everybody's down to earth. So the party was fun, That's what I got. So
when you texted me and you were like, I'm going to go back up, I'm like, I knew you were going to go back up.
I almost went up Friday.
On the train ride home, you're like, I'm not going to go back. I'm not going to go back. And then the next day, you're like, I'm going to go back.
Well, I went back. I took a day off.
Yeah,
you
took a day off. And I wanted to go, but I had to. I had a Halloween party to attend.
Yeah, how was it?
It was good.
Yeah.
Nice, friendly environment with all my friends, and just dressed up and
what were you?
Drank some I Shoot Raw beverages.
And what were you dressed as?
I was dressed as a motocross rider, which mainly was because that I needed a last-minute idea, and I have a dirt bike, and I had my outfit laying around. If I didn't go to PPE or shoot a concert event on Friday, then I would have had time to go out and check some stuff out. But.
It's Friday. Yesterday was Thursday, Saturday, Sunday.
Monday.
Yeah! Rebecca Black.
Did you hear that Chinese food song?
I heard it today. I was listening to Hollywood Babylon, Kevin Smith's and Ralph Garman's thing.
Yeah.
And they played it. But it has 11 million views.
Oh, well, yeah, because.
And I'm sure they. On the Billboard chart in the top 100.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, that's crazy.
It just keeps working.
Model, and it's the same guy who was producing the Friday song, right?
Basically, you pay him $5,000 and he'll put your kid in a music video and film it professionally.
Make it terrible and give him a bad reputation.
Yeah, it just
give him 11 million views and put him out there in the spotlight.
But they don't make any money. He makes the money on it. He does make money off of it.
It's all uploaded to his site. I'm assuming he's making all the YouTube traffic.
He makes all the YouTube money.
Yeah.
Because he owns it.
I'm sure.
All right. So we have Gear of the Week, Steven.
Yes.
We're going to talk about this. This is the Color Checker Passport from X-Rite. I've had this for, a year and never opened it? I opened it to look at it and sniff it.
I love it, personally.
But you've had it. So that's why I pulled it out for you to talk about. Tell everybody tell everybody, give them a brief rundown and overview of what this thing does.
Basically, what it does is it gives your camera a custom color profile that you basically load into Lightroom. You do it while you're on location doing a shoot or whatever. You take out the actual passport, you take a picture of it, you bring it into Lightroom, it makes a custom color profile and calibrates pretty much Lightroom for you and sets all the color toward what your camera should be, and depending on the lighting and all that stuff.
Well,
And basically, it makes your skin tones look surreal, like so perfect, and every color that you see on at the shoot, it's just perfect.
Well, so it's really ideally for shooting product,
yep,
and shooting models. Well, in situations where the lighting isn't going to change drastically.
You want
to
have continuous lighting. This is not an environment. This is not something to have when you're, you know, shooting a sunset or a concert. Yeah, like it's only when you have a controlled environment that you're shooting.
And I've seen it.
So I've only used it a couple of times because I don't typically do that.
Right, but in the studio or when you're doing a product, say you have to shoot 500 items. You get one color setting,
yep,
you put this thing out, you take a picture of it, and then you click on the white, correct?
Yeah, well, basically what you do first is you, it has a white card in it too, or gray card. And you set your white balance first, and then you go and you, if I remember correctly, you go and actually take the picture of this, and that's when you bring into Lightroom. You set your white balance by clicking on that, and then from there you... Yeah, it calibrates it for you.
So it gets your color perfectly right?
It really does get it perfectly right. And a lot of people are like, nah, it doesn't, blah, blah, blah. Or if a lot of people are wondering why your skin tones are never realistic looking when you're doing a shoot, get this thing. And I mean, it will change your world when it comes to shooting anything with continuous light.
Well, yeah, if you need to have
Not continuous light, I just mean a controlled environment.
Yeah, well, it's the proper white balance,
exactly.
Basically. It's the right skin tones, especially when you're shooting... And X-Rite, they also make...
they make all the color correction software.
Yeah, and color correction for your monitors. Mm-hmm. The reason you want to use those is if you are shooting product, it has to be that color because it has to... if you're going to sell it, it has to be representative of what you're selling.
Yep.
So that's why this thing comes in handy and is definitely worth checking out if you do the studio stuff, if you do portraits and product like that. If you're just running and gunning all day long, you're not going to take the time to use something like this.
Well, you really can't. Yeah.
Well, that's why I haven't used it myself.
And the nice thing is when you do it in Lightroom, when you import it, all you literally do is you download the plugin, you export it, it makes that custom DNG profile, and you're set. It's
so
that easy.
I didn't want to interrupt you, but you said alls. That's
when did
a Philly
I say alls?
Thing.
Just now?
Yeah.
Did I?
Yeah. Is that something you're
working? Did I really say alls?
Use it alls.
I guess it is, yeah.
It's a Philly thing.
I didn't
thing.
Even catch myself. Usually I'll catch myself and correct.
It's a Jersey
especially
slash Philly
with the
thing.
Radio stuff.
Well, you know, yeah, because you remember we talked about Photo. Somebody came up to me at the Photo Plus show and was like, yeah, I'm from Philly. I say water also.
You know, water. Like,
water. Not water.
Water.
Water. But no, the same thing. You notice that people say alls I had to do or use guys.
We use guys. I tend to throw that out sometimes. I don't mean to, but I
don't say use guys.
I'm so used to it by now. You know what I mean?
We never.
Wit or wit out
is different. But
I was just at Geno's last weekend, actually.
You like Geno's or you like Pat's?
Well, I prefer Jim's over all of them, but I went to Geno's because my friends are there.
I still like Steve's.
Yeah.
Steve's Prince of Steak.
I've been to Steve's.
There's one in the Northeast.
I don't really like cheesesteak places to begin with, but... When you're drinking I Shoot Raw beverages for a while, it's usually
how late are they
open? To go to. I don't know. It was like 3 a.m. by that point.
For anybody that doesn't
definitely
know,
late.
Philly, if you don't know, Philly's a home of the cheesesteak, and there's some places in Philly. There's a million places to get it, but there's Geno's and Pat's in off of Passyunk Avenue, correct? Passyunk? There's, don't ask me how to spell Passyunk, but there's... Two steak places. One is like neon lights and all upscale looking. Not really upscale looking, but better looking than the other one. And the other is on the other side of the road. They're right across the street. Certain people will only eat at Pat's and certain others will only eat at Geno's.
Yep.
It's just one of those things.
Well, Geno's seems to be like the sold out brand because that's kind of like when, if you're not from around the area, you heard of Geno's first. I mean, that's the place. That's the one with all the lights and all that crazy stuff. But yeah, personally, I think... Pat's and Jim's are a little better, and Steve's, I guess. I haven't been there yet.
I like Steve's. You like Jim's.
Yeah.
The only thing
just
I don't...
Just because Geno's is so busy. They're just, like, slapping on meat and throwing it out there. And
like at the AVN Awards.
That was a good one. Yeah.
I like Jim's, but the only thing I don't like about Jim's is they don't have French fries. I'm a big connoisseur of fries.
I'm a huge French fry guy.
Then you'd like Steve's.
Yeah.
Steve's fries are fantastic.
I got to check it out.
Yeah. Maybe we'll take a trip one day. I think we need to start. What I read in Inc. magazine today is about...
We should go to Jim's and Geno's
we should
pick up a cheesesteak.
We should do, what are those things called? Team building exercises. No, basically they talked about getting out. There were some companies in here that well, they had GoPro for one. There's a nice couple paragraphs from the founder of GoPro talking about how they get out of the office and how every year now they rent out like Magic Kingdom or some big theme park and invite all the family members and all the employees, and they go and they record and they have fun. I mean, it's already a fun place to work because they're always recording this stuff. Oh, what it talks about is they don't make cameras. They make cool shit. I forget what he said. I can't exact term.
It's like, I think of Google. I mean,
he mentioned Google too. Google didn't make a search engine. They set out to do something else. Go ahead. Keep going. I'll find it.
With Google, they have a campus, right? I think they call it the campus.
Oh, yeah.
And literally has everything you can think of on there, from like sleeping and nap time quarters to like you can rent a bike and ride around the campus. It's literally like a college campus, yet you're working at it and you can take all the breaks that you want.
Oh, yeah.
It's crazy.
Here's what it says. And this is from the guy who founded GoPro. Our mission is to make it easy for people to self-document and share meaningful experiences. You'll notice I didn't say we make cameras and camera mounts.
Interesting.
As soon as it becomes about the camera, it's rather limited. So basically, they're selling you the sizzle, not the steak. What is the camera going to do for you? What does a GoPro mean? It means that lifestyle. It means that, and this is great for marketing and branding and everything that anybody does, especially in sales. I know this from sales. As my dad hammered home to me since I was a little kid, sell the sizzle, not the steak. And what that means is don't sit there and read the box to people. When I started to sell cameras, he's like, don't sit there and read the specs.
Read the
anybody can read
it.
The specs. Come up and say, you know, what is this camera going to do for you? And be like, you see, they have a kid there. You know, this is going to allow you to capture great images of your kids running around at the park, when they're swimming, at the birthday party. And people say this when I was sell. They'd be like, how many megapixels is it? And I'd be like, honestly, no idea. But that's not what it's about. It's about what you're going to capture with this. It doesn't matter if you have 8 million megapixels. Sorry. It doesn't matter if you have 8 trillion megapixels or 4 megapixels. If you don't know what you're doing, it doesn't matter. And I'm sure I would come off wrong to some people like that, but I would just flat out say, you know, what do you, the simple questions in sales are, what are you going to use the camera for? What are you looking to capture? It's always this or that. My dad taught me a lot, and I watched him do sales all the time. So you learn things. Say there's 30 cameras to offer, and I'm just going to give a lesson to anybody out there in sales. Take this for whatever you want. But say you have 30 cameras to choose from. You've got point and shoots. You've got cell phone cameras. You have DSLRs. You have all of these different options facing people when they come to a camera store. You have to qualify them really quick. Qualify them, meaning what are they there to get? So it's like, hey, are you looking for a point and shoot or a DSLR? So right there, I've got qualifiers. So they either say, what's a DSLR? And most likely, you know that they may not be looking for that.
Yeah.
And then you go, okay, the difference is this and this. And they go, oh, no, I wasn't looking for that. I'm looking for a point and shoot. So now you just went from 30 down to 8 choices. And from there you go, well, what is your budget? What were you hoping to get? Were you looking were you looking for a little pocket camera?
Yeah.
Or were you looking for something with big zoom? So now you went from 8 to 3. And then you get it down to 2 and you're like, all right, here's what we have. And then the best close ever. You know when people are trying to close, when you need to make the deal. There's the way to do it. And my dad called it the fatal alternative, which is, I'm sure, a term that everybody else in marketing has used. The fatal alternative. When people are either kicking, you have to determine whether they're kicking tires or just,
if they're just browsing,
if they're just browsing or they're ready to buy, you ask a question. You have to come up with the fatal alternative. Would you like to go with an 8 gig card or a 16 gig card? Right? What are the options that they can say? They're going to say either I'll take the 8. Or you know what? I'm not ready to buy today.
Yeah.
But they have to answer it one way or another. You just closed them. You just said you need to make a decision right now. Now, you're not forcing a decision. You just, depending on the time that you've spent, it's all a feel. There's times where you don't need to hover over a person when they're thinking about it. Just be like, all right, here are these two options. You know what? I'm going to go I got to go check on something. Why don't you sit here and play with this? And then you come back and you go, so what you think? You know? Oh, this is great. This is great. All right. We've got these cards or these cards. Which would you like? And right there, they have to make their mind up. And if they say, you know what? I'm not ready to buy today. You have your card. You write your name on it. You say, when you're ready to come back and see me. We'll help you out. Take as much time as you need.
Yeah. That's
fatal
good.
Alternative, man.
I never heard of that. I mean, I'm not really a sales guy to begin with.
I'm sure. Yeah. But it becomes more recognizable now when you hear good salespeople talk to you.
Definitely.
I get people on the phone all the time or wherever I'm at, and they try to close me, and I go, nice close. Like, I know what you're talking to a salesperson, so I know what you're doing.
I just hate when they try to like almost force it upon you. Like, it's,
I tell a salesperson, I sit there and I go,
like, without you even saying yes or no, like, about that 8 or 16 gig card, yeah, they're automatically, like, being like, okay, so you're going to get this 32 gig card. You know what I mean? Like, no, that's when it really annoys me.
I personally sit there, and if somebody ever is pushy, I say, look, I'm here to make my own decisions.
Yep.
I'm asking you questions because you're the quote-unquote expert in this field. Or, I mean, you're the salesperson. And I'm going to take whatever knowledge you have, and we're going to then make a decision. I'm going to go ahead and make a decision. And that's good. A good salesperson will read a person like me and know that they're not going to be able to sell me.
Yep.
If they try to sell me bullshit, I'm going to walk out and be like, dude, I don't need you
we
to tell me what
that
to do.
One day.
What?
Go into a store and you should try and, like, buy a camera and see what they do to see what they say.
Oh, it's so bad. Oh, you want to do undercover?
We should have, like, a GoPro or something.
You want to do
it?
I
don't know if we could, like, legally do it. I'm sure we could, right?
Screw it.
Yeah.
You just do it.
I think that'd be good.
We should go into Best Buy.
But you probably have to hide the fro.
I'll go in with my...
if the camera guy knows who you are.
Shit. I forgot about that.
Yeah. Just wear your shower cap.
Well, I told you one time I was at Best Buy. And I do this. If I ever go to Best Buy or I go to a store, I like to go into the photo section
to either
help people, because I end up helping. Like, hey, I don't work here, but do you have any questions? Some people look at me weird and they're like, who the hell are you? I'm like, don't worry about it. I'll help you. And then I give them information. And, well, I just like helping.
You're like, don't buy any of this crap right here. Right. Go over there.
Well, I was standing there one day and the guy was showing somebody a Nikon. The guy was showing them a Canon DSLR. And he's like, the Canon's, you know, more for video. If you're going to be wanting to take more of stills, then it's more like Nikon, which isn't far off.
A very general statement, but yeah.
But it's not far off.
It's not.
Right? But these people don't know what they want. They have a little girl with them. They want to get kit pictures. They want to get good video. The guy...
But they won't know the difference in the video.
The next statement he makes, he goes, if you want to read up on a website, go to kenrockwell.com. He knows everything. And I stepped in right there. I'm like, don't go to kenrockwell.com. And the guy's
won't come on my podcast.
The guy's like, who are you? And this is before that. He goes, yeah, go to kenrockwell.com. It's great. I'm like, don't go to Ken Rockwell. Here's my card. I'm like, I'll give you a free video guide just to learn, because don't go to that guy's website. And this kid didn't know who I was, which is fine. But he's sitting there promoting Ken. I'm like, don't do that. The guy's an asshole. I mean, sorry. His information is terrible.
I was going to say, you've never met him, have you?
No, I've never met him. We've never talked on the phone. There's been emails.
Yeah.
I sent him an iShoot Raw. I sent him this shirt.
Did you?
Yes. He said...
Did he cross out the RAW and put JPEG?
I asked him to take a picture with wearing it, because obviously I'd get a lot of traction with that. and he's like, I was about to go out and my wife was like, you're not going anywhere in that shirt.
Oh my God.
And I was like, come on, grow a pair, dude. Seriously.
That's awesome.
Anyway,
Let's move on to the flying solo. It's not flying solo. It's the PPE.
Well, it's the PPE flying solo part.
I don't know if you had anything else to bring up, though.
Why are you trying to interrupt me?
I don't know. It's the iShoot Raw beverage talking right now.
Well, I'm perfectly fine, Steven. You can't be drunk off of an iShoot Raw beverage. So we talked about the color checker. Anybody looking for the FroKnowsPhoto Black Rapid iShoot Raw Edition strap? They are back in stock at store.froknowsphoto.com. And Squarespace. If you've checked out jaredpolin.com, you'll see that I now officially use... Well, actually, you won't even see that it's Squarespace, because you kind of don't know it unless I tell you. But I love how simple and easy it is to set up. Steven has to go take his 14-day free trial.
I do.
And
I still
use
need
it.
To.
But you can get a 14-day free trial. Go to squarespace.com/fro. And if you go ahead and check out, if you decide you want to purchase their service, you can get 10% off your first purchase. So if you get it for a year, you're going to get 10% off the first year of service by using code FRO. We'll go FRO 11 because it's going to be November when this comes out.
Yep.
So FRO 11 is the number for you to use to get that code. Anyway, flying solo, Steven. You're going to stay here this week for me, right?
Yep.
Yeah, because you don't have a mic set up over there. And we don't have that many. I put this out there. I'm like, everybody on Facebook, let's have a theme again. Because it's like, might as well ask your questions. Because if you were... What was that?
Someone breaking into your apartment. I don't know.
Did they knock? Was that a knock on my door?
I don't think so, but it sounded like it was on this floor.
Maybe my neighbor's upset.
Oh, he's like, I'm trying to get to bed. Now, what time is it? Let's see. It is... Oh, it's 10:30 now.
Is it really?
Yeah. Have we been talking that long?
I guess. It could be the other neighbor.
No, I think that neighbor's pretty cool. I don't know about that one.
Oh, I got a story to tell you about them. Oh, boy. Wait. I can't say it here.
Oh, it's you. I was like, what is that?
That's my butt. I can't say it here. Anyway, so I put out the questions there. I was like, everybody let me know what you want to know about Photo Plus if you couldn't be there. So the first question here is from Bill Rogers. You got to meet Bill.
My man
and
Bill.
You got to hang out with Bill. Bill, I shot his wedding. Bill's an awesome guy. And it's funny. He goes, please let me know what time you're recording so I can text you and interrupt again. Remember he interrupted last week? And yeah. I was like, that's Bill. And I guarantee you I know what his question was. And when
and
I read
it was
it
the
after
exact
the fact,
same question.
It was the question, should I go with a 600 refurb or should I buy a 610?
Yep.
Anyway, so I didn't tell him what time we were on. So we got Dan.
So he couldn't interrupt.
Yeah, Dan Yule. Hey, Jared, I was wondering if you were doing the Antonelli Scholarship this year. Now, this has nothing to do with Photo Plus, but for anybody out there, for the past, I think it's been 2 years, I put out a scholarship at Antonelli. What are you looking at?
Just checking time. We're good. We got 10
time
minutes.
Time is on my side. Yes, it is. Time is on my side. Oh, yes, it is. Rolling Stones, buddy. Anyway, Dan Yule. So I started giving a scholarship at Antonelli to a first-year student 2 years ago when I wasn't making a lot of money, but I knew that it would be something good to do.
It's cool that you did that.
So I did that 2 years ago. I did it last year, and I ended up doubling the scholarship and splitting it with two people.
Sam Green was one of them.
Sam Green
he?
Ended up being one, and another kid obviously ended up being the other. So I'm going to do it a little different this year. I'm going to make. Usually we did it over the summer, but now that the kids have had pretty much half a year to be in there, I want them to tell me a photo story. I want them to capture a photo story, something that's passionate, and then put it into a video. But it doesn't have to be a video. You
like
know what I mean?
A slideshow, you mean?
Just a slideshow.
Okay.
Maybe with voiceovers. Just do something.
That's kind of like what I had to do for my photojournalism class, actually, in college.
I want to hear these stories. I want to see that people went out there and thought about it and did something. And they don't have to do the voiceover themselves. It could be a voiceover with a friend. It could be just a musical overlay.
I was
going to
say, what if it was just music that
that's
tells
fine.
The story?
That's fine, too. Lyrically. It's whatever they want to do, but I'm just telling you what I would be looking for. So I got to get in touch with the school again and tell them that's what I want to do this
we
year.
Actually went on the train with Drew from
yeah,
Antonelli.
Drew Simcox, he was
randomly
my teacher there.
Saw him there, that was cool.
He was in line with us. We went on the train and we
talked
went
the whole
New
train
York.
Ride yeah.
Yeah, he wanted to get work done
and he didn't.
I tried to let him work.
I know, he kept asking the questions.
Drew talks a lot.
He does.
Drew's a big talker.
He's a good man.
Drew's great. He's one of the best teachers I've ever had. Stuart Levine.
I don't know. Is
Adam
it like
Levine?
Adam Levine?
L-E-V-I-N-E. That's Levine.
Levine. It could be either or.
Levine.
I think Levine is usually, but I don't know.
All right. Let's go beyond the typical what's new and disappointment questions. What with that, I offer up this. What one item or demonstration did you see at the show would either enhance your current take on photography or significantly change your approach to capturing images?
Photography wise or video wise?
Anything.
Well, for me, Lee, I think for us, the Ninja 2 was a big thing that we saw. We're trying to see, we wanted to get an option for doing uncompressed clean out pretty much out of, for our GoPro angle instead of having GoPro having like a 14 to 24 on a DSLR.
So let me explain it. The Ninja by Atomos.
Yep.
Is that what they're called?
I
Atomos?
Think,
or
yeah.
Atomos?
I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but
I
yeah.
don't know how to say it, but it's just, it's, literally this big, and you drop a 2.5-inch hard drive, spinning one, or a SSD in there, mm-hmm. and it has a touch screen on the back, and it runs HDMI from the camera into this device, which then allows us to run whatever camera we're running. We don't have to get up and
continuous.
Do 20 minutes anymore, because mm-hmm. it's continuous as long as you have battery, which is why you get an AC adapter, and then you have as much space on the hard drive as you need. That's what you do. So you could get like 11 hours at the highest rating, which is the full yeah. 422 or whatever
well,
it is.
Well, and he was saying it was like a 2 terabyte drive or something like that, right?
It was like a 1 terabyte drive. Yeah. He said 11 hours.
I mean, that would be insane if
we
did
don't
that
want
every
that.
Week. Yeah.
We want to do just the basic, almost what a digital SLR would do anyway. So that's why we want to switch this GoPro camera angle out so that we can get a better side angle, better color, better...
no more auto crappy exposure.
Yeah, white balance is set. But that's what we want to do. Yeah, you're right. That is the one thing that we saw demonstrated that...
At least for me, yeah, that was that kind of blew me away.
I agree. That's something that was the most impressive thing that I... Well, not most impressive, but one of the things that I was there looking for.
And the stabilizer that the one company showed me.
It was the
but,
same company.
Yeah, no, it wasn't the same company. It was a separate company, but they had
Oh, they were showing it?
Yeah. He was just walking around the floor. Man, oh, I forget right. the name of it, but... this thing was crazy, but really expensive.
All right, so we got that. It was $3,000, by the way.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
And the
but that only held like a pound, I think.
Right, it was a small camera, but the Ninja's only $600.
Yeah, it's
something
cheap.
Like $600
for the entry level, I think, model.
So Ninja, we'd like one.
Yes,
or three.
Definitely, three would be perfect.
And I may buy them anyway. Junior Wyatt, what are some of the positives and some of the negatives from the show? From the standpoint of a consumer, basically, if you're a consumer, I think it's a win-win. If you've never been to a show like this, I definitely would consider going. Like I said earlier, that's the positive, is that you can do that, meet other photographers. You are surrounded by a couple thousand at a time, 10, 12,000 other photographers in the building that are interested in the same thing that you're interested in. So I highly recommend that just for networking. Not even networking to try to get job, but just talking to people that are into the same thing that you're talking about. Yeah. You know, just like at AVN. negatives, there was really not much new this year to see. I thought the booths were pretty crappy.
Well, see, I can't really comment on that. But
yeah, Nikon booth was really boring. Canon's booth was the same as it always is, which is very plain, but has a ton of stuff. They even have calculators. But it's a nice booth because you have everything out there. I just want to see more. I want to see stuff. I want to see things going on. But they're very corporate, so they don't really do too many things out there. The Sony booth was huge. We'll talk about that coming up.
I saw the Olympus booth had a girl on like a rope swinging around.
Oh, they did.
Crap?
They had an acrobatic girl up there.
That was pretty cool. That's probably about it as far as that stuff goes.
Alex Medvik, did you get to play with the new 58 1.4 from Nikon? Any idea what the big deal is about? I know it's supposed to be a harken back to the Nok 1.2 of the old days, but what is that even supposed to mean? Well, this 58 1.4 is supposed. I didn't play with it. I didn't wait in line. I didn't feel like the Nikon booth just upsets me every time.
I didn't think we saw it, did we?
Yeah, I saw it out there. It's huge. It's a huge hunk of glass. It's kind of like the 1.2, but it's not a 1.2. It's an 80. It's a 58 1.4, so it could be the same size as an 85. It's meant to be this, like he said, throwback to an old time, and this 1.2 knock, which I honestly don't even know what it means. I know that it was this older lens, but it's supposed to be extremely sharp. The 58 is supposed to be a beautiful angle to shoot at. So that's what it is, but it's so damn expensive that I can't see too many people buying it.
It is expensive. That's very expensive.
Yeah. All right. Matthew Dunlap, thanks for all your hard work. I am an enthusiast shooting with the A99 and absolutely love its features. Have you been able to open up a dialogue with Sony to get anything for review?
We talked to them about it.
And then I ended up laying on their carpet for an hour.
Because you were camouflaged.
In the video. Yeah, I was wearing an orange shirt, and you're gonna see in the video what happened. Did we open up any dialogue? We had dialogue with a guy in the booth, but it didn't really lead anywhere.
We saw the new, what's it called?
It's a cell phone camera.
The cell phone camera,
I don't know what it's called.
Thingy.
I think it's going to fail. I don't think anybody cares about that anymore.
It looked kind of cool, but when he was demonstrating it to us, it like wouldn't work.
It wouldn't connect. It wouldn't sync
up. But it might have just been a simple...
Well, it's because it was a Sony phone.
Yeah.
Does anybody use a Sony phone out there?
Well, you just need the Play Memory app, I think, to actually run it. So I think any phone can do it, but yeah, maybe because it was that. But we talked about how we wanted, why don't you guys send us stuff?
And they knew who we were, and we're like, we just want to play with the gear. Just like everybody else sends us gear to play with, we'll send it back. We don't want to keep it. So people want to talk about that A7 and the A7R.
Mm-hmm. Which we did check out.
We checked it out. You know, it's
tiny.
It's tiny. That harkens back to an older style camera, the way that it's shaped and the way that it has dials and buttons on the back. Is it going to be great? We'll see. We'll see what competitors come out in the market and if there is anything out there to compete with it. But it's definitely a mirrorless camera that's going to go out there and try something different.
Oh, yeah.
All right. So let's move on. We got a couple more, and then it's time to see the video.
Yeah, we're almost an hour in.
No way.
Yeah.
What?
It's going to be a long one.
Oh, geez.
Hopefully this video isn't over half an hour.
Richard Ritter, what booth did you spend the most time at and why? Also, what was the best tchotchke giveaway at the show?
Tchotchke.
There weren't really... I didn't see many giveaways at the show.
I was too busy filming, so I couldn't really pay attention. I just saw people with the bags, and I know there was a ton of giveaways.
Well, when we are press, what was in the press giveaway bag?
The press giveaway bag, there was
a bag.
I think a bag, obviously. We had the book bag. We had, I think, the Joby USB charger.
That was cool.
AC charger.
AC charger with two USB plugs.
There was a bunch of stickers, a bunch of test prints. I didn't really look through it that much yet, but well, there's a lot of stickers.
There's a bunch of lens cloths in there.
Lens cloths.
DxO Mark?
DxO Mark, what do you mean?
We went and saw them.
We did. We talked to them. And you had an interesting conversation with
them.
I
did. I got to remember not to go in there with my negativity like that first. And I'm
I think I brought it back under normal tense.
I'm like, why am I telling them that I hate their product first?
Directly
I should
in front
save
of
that
them.
To the end. But they explained everything. They gave us some free copies to play with.
They did.
It's pretty impressive.
The guy emailed me after. So.
He emailed me too, and I saw him the next day, and he smacked me on the arm when I walked by.
We saw the one French dude like a million times.
Yeah. Basically, the software is pretty powerful. What they were showing.
It was.
And I just the stuff. I wasn't yelling at their software. Like their software does what they say it's going to do, and I guess it does a good job. The thing that I was more up in arms about is that. They encourage the pixel beeping by doing all of these tests with lenses, but that's their thing. I don't bemoan them for that. That's their thing, right?
But I mean, I think of like DP review too. I mean, I'm sure
DP review is very technical.
Exactly, but that's what they're trying to get to.
But DxO does it so that they can go ahead and sell you on the fact that if you use their software, they're going to correct for lens errors that they find with their stuff. Anyway, back to that. I didn't spend a lot of time in very many booths at all.
No.
We were packed for 8 hours. We were going around doing the work that we needed to get done. We went to the Black Rapid booth. I hung out there, I guess, for a little bit.
Trying to think of where we
said
stopped
hi
at.
To the think tank people. We went to lunch.
The Ninja one we stopped at for
we
a little bit.
We stopped at Ninja. The things that we wanted to see, we stopped and did.
Yeah, I don't know who else we really did.
That's about it, really.
It is about
that.
It, yeah.
All right, three more. Photos by Ricardo. Not so much a question, but I have to say it was great experience. The guys in CPS were so, CPS is Canon Professional Services, mm-hmm. so accommodating when I'm a European member. Some great seminars. Peter Hurley's party rocked, and it got me a copy of the Fro Flash Guide.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, because he ran into me.
You?
I did. I brought some with me. One guy did win one for saying Squints Paladora.
Nice.
Walked up and said Squints Paladora. So he got that.
That's cool. Forgot
and then,
about that.
And then Ricardo here got one, and I believe he's Scott. Oh, is he Irish?
Irish, Scottish.
But I don't want to mix it up because they hate each other.
Yeah.
I think he's Irish.
Scottish is a little harder, I feel like, to understand. Well, it depends
but
where
I
you're from
his
in
accent.
The area. But yeah.
I love the accent.
Yeah.
I understood what he was saying. I had to think harder, you know, just to interpret it, but it was awesome. It's just so cool when you have readers and fans, just people in general from around the world who come up to you and want to take your picture and want to get their picture with you and just talk.
Which was every 5 minutes.
Well, but it's fantastic. It feels great.
No, it was.
That's why I enjoyed going back
it.
Up Saturday.
Yeah.
Because it's just, it's nice to walk around and people are like, oh, can I talk?
Someone like you could just go by yourself and be totally content the entire time because you have people to talk to.
All by myself.
Everything I say somehow brings up a song.
All by myself. Don't wanna be all by myself. Guido Budani. Budani. Question for Steven. That's why it's here, because it's for
oh,
you.
Oh, nice.
70 to 40 f4 or 16 to 35 2.8 on a budget.
Wait, what? 70 to 40?
17 to 40 f4.
Oh, I thought you said 70.
Or 16 to 35 2.8 on a budget, and I don't have a wide angle. Thanks for all the raw talks, guys. Cheers from the Argentinian community.
He's debating on which one to get. I mean,
in your opinion,
in my opinion, I would say the 16 to 35. But if he's on a budget, 17 to 40 is probably the way to go.
Or just
I
actually, save up your money.
I actually owned both of those lenses, and the F4 is the one I had originally, which I think is about almost half the price as the other one. They're both sharp as hell, so it's really not an issue. It depends really how much light you need. I mean, if you're shooting low light stuff, go for the 2.8. If not, for me personally, I've learned the hard way that you need to just save up your money and get the best stuff you can get because these lenses are going to last forever. I went the wrong route and got the 17 to 40 first, sold it for less money, then ended up getting the 16 to 35 anyway.
And again, people, we don't sit here and tell you that if you don't have a 2.8 that your lens is crap.
Oh yeah.
I get that comment all the time.
Plenty.
People are like, oh, do you think that the lens is crap if you don't have a 2.8? No, we understand that things are expensive and sometimes you start somewhere. The points that we try to make is that when you can afford or you are saving up, don't spend $500 when for $800 or $900, if you saved up a little longer, you could get a lens. every lens that I have in my bag right now, Steven, I could sell my 14 to 24 for more than I paid for it because the price actually went up over the years.
Interesting.
And the 24 to 70, the price went up. I could pretty much trade them out for new lenses.
Yeah.
Actually, no, I couldn't. I could sell them and then put it into new lenses. But that's the thing. Good glass carries its value as for the next 5-6 years, and you don't have to worry about it.
I bought half of mine used, and I can probably still sell at the same price.
Well, that's the thing. I pay $2,200 for my 70 to 200. Mm-hmm. If I go and sell it in 4 or 5 years, I'm going to get $1,800 or $1,900, especially if there's not a new one out yet. You're still get $1,700, $1,800. So what I do, rent a lens for $300 or $400 for 5 years?
Yep.
Think about it.
And the other thing is, too, I mean, it comes down to the quality of glass. These are both, I believe, both L lenses. I mean, the glass is the same. It just it depends, if you're shooting in low light or not. I have a 2.8 lens. I barely even shoot at 2.8 half the time.
Yeah.
You know, I'm usually at 3.5 if I need to go down. But it's really just depends on budget-wise and what you can afford.
All right. So, Steven, I'm reversing what I said earlier. I'm going to do my sign out now instead of waiting till people are done watching the other video.
Whatever you want to do.
So what's going to happen right now? That's pretty much the end of Raw Talk episode 59, which ended up being a long one. I want to thank you guys for listening. Coming up when I'm done talking and signing out is the rundown, the video that Steven has cut of our time up at Photo Plus, so you can see the fun we had and the trouble we almost got in and the sniff test. Well, I didn't do a lot of sniff tests, but maybe I sniffed that carpet.
You did some.
I did?
I think you did the Sony. Didn't you do the Sony?
Well, I didn't want to sniff it because too many hands were on it.
Oh, I don't know. You didn't do too many. I didn't do too many,
but I did have handcuffs with me. You'll see why during the video. So really appreciate you guys listening week in and week out. Thank you guys for doing that. If you haven't subscribed on the podcast, you can do so over there on iTunes or in Android or anywhere else that you can subscribe. I want to thank allenscamera.com. Check them out. Thanks Squarespace. Go to squarespace.com/fro. Use code FRO11 and save 10% on your first order. And don't forget the flash guide, froknowsphoto.com/flash guide, if you want to check out the flash guide that is there. And that is it, Steven. I really appreciate you being here again late night.
Yes, sir.
And you guys pay attention to this video. Enjoy it. Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com. See ya. Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com, and welcome to New York City as we are going to go through the Photo Plus Expo 2013. We're going to take you from booth to booth, or as many booths as possible, and see what we come up with and if we can get into any trouble with the handcuffs and figure out what they are for. I don't know. I went with pink handcuffs because hopefully I could lock myself to somebody in Nikon's booth. We'll see what happens. So I hope you enjoy this as we walk around. Maybe you'll pick up something interesting, see some new toys or gizmos or gadgets, or just enjoy watching it all together. Here we go. Quick tour of the floor. Let's follow me. Steven, you got me? We good? Shake that up and down. Yeah? All right. So here we got the Nikon booth over here, which is always yellow. Canon has their booth over here every year. Now Sony's booth, which is now right in front of us, keeps getting bigger and bigger every year. Why don't we walk through here, Steve, see what we've got? I don't have permission yet to be in here, but I'm gonna do it. You know what, Steven? You think they'll let me in there to dance? No? What do you think? I have to get in there and dance. They should have a fish tank for this stuff. You can't even get to it to test it out. The Nikon 1 AW1. This is their display. If it was me, I would have a fish tank and I would let people shoot pictures on a rod or something to see what works. Very disappointed, Steven. Very disappointed. I have a chance to win a car, everybody. You could be driving away in this GMC 2014 Acadia or Terrain. Could be yours.
$29.95. What do I have to do? I don't want to register online. I just want to take it home. Oh, the door opens. Who knew? Did nobody think about locking this just in case somebody like me came here to do this? We'll do a sniff. Oh, it smells so good. Oh my God, it smells like a car, Steven. It's like a car. Sorry. I'm not sorry. I bring my own handcuffs just in case they want to arrest me. We're going to use my own. Come on! Aluminized metal print. Aluminized metal print. No 4x6, no 4x6, no whammies. No whammies. Stop! Oh, 8x10 canvas print. I got an aluminized print. So good. Sony, make dot believe.
That's what it says up there, make dot believe. Is that like make believe, but with a dot in it? I don't know, but here we get to stare at technicians. Let's see if we can get their concentration all good. How we doing? Let's see how long he can ignore me. That's right. They put these people in a booth for whatever reason, I don't know. It's like being at the zoo. You get to watch. Will something happen? You know what usually happens at the zoo, Steven? The tortoises, the male tortoise and then the female tortoise, they start to copulate and it's just bad. I've seen it happen. So I don't know if it's going to happen here. Look at those tweezers. This is major stuff. These guys are unshakable. Unshakable. You can't even get them to look at you.
Show them the handcuffs.
No, I'm not going to show them the handcuffs. Ah, it's not working, Steven. It's not working. All right, you want to walk through the Sony booth?
Sure.
See, what I like about the booth, Sony, Steven, look at this. Orange carpet. When you go into Nikon, you don't even have yellow carpet in there. And in Canon, they don't even have red. Orange. Oh, it matches my... I'm not even here. I'm blending into the Sony booth. Does anybody see me? I'm blending in. Are we good? Blending? You don't see me, do you? I'm blending in, right? You don't even see me? I'm like carpet. I'm like carpet now. Whew! Nobody saw me. I blended into that. That's right. Yes. Let's see if we can get an A7 in our hands. Maybe. Will Sony talk to me? Sony never talks to me. They ignore me. They don't send me emails. They don't send me press stuff. They don't let me. Are you with Sony? I mean, it says Sony on his shirt. Should I wait?
What do you need?
What I need, my readers at home say, Jared, why don't you review Sony gear?
That's a good question.
And I go, well, Sony doesn't send me any gear to play with, to then send back, because I don't want to keep it. I want to just use it.
Why wouldn't you want to keep it?
Because unless you're going to give it to me.
Good point.
I never expect to keep any gear that anybody sends. It's one of those misconceptions. People at home think that people send us free gear and we keep
it. It's loaner gear.
It's loaner gear. And you send it back. Sorry. Did you see me blend into the carpet?
You really are.
It was awesome.
Great.
Anyway, I'll talk to you when we go through. We'll finish shooting. We'll do a tour.
And take a look at everything.
All right. Where's the new A7?
It's going to be closer to the end.
I have a question. He can't answer this, and we don't have a mic on him. So I'm just going to maybe fill in words for him. I know. Sorry. Let's get your name, Anthony. This is a very... Oh, snap. Can I try it? This is thing. There's on and off. On and off.
You gotta press it.
I did press it like a big boy. There we go. So this is like totally that camera thing that goes on your... I just took a picture of you, Steven. I took another picture of you. Took a picture of me. All right. Here you go, Anthony. So my question to Sony, and I may just answer it myself, is what is with the XQD card? I own a D4. Okay. It is the only freaking camera on the market that takes that damn thing, and you guys aren't even supporting it in your own cameras. Very upsetting.
Currently, right now, at the moment.
Yes.
The D4 is the only thing that uses
it. It's another... Yeah, it's the only thing that's ever going to use it.
You know I can't answer that.
Yeah, no. So I'm gonna put words in his mouth. Anthony, is that all right? Anthony is not saying these words.
I cannot say these words.
Sony will never go further with the XQD card, ever. It is another failure in the industry. Amongst a lot of successes, yes. XQD, like beta. I still have my beta player. Right. Jared Polin, FroKnowsPhoto.com, here in the Sony booth with the A7R. What's it smell like? I don't want to smell it because too many people have been touching it and we don't know where their hands have been. But this is it. It feels really like a point and shoot, but it has nice dials that turn back here. You have the nice on... Well, the on and off switch is kind of weird. It's in a weird place. I would have expected the shutter button to be somewhere around here, not so much up here. It's a little awkward in that feeling first right off the bat. Let's see, we'll go into manual and see how the controls move. Well, that's intuitive. That's pretty easy and quick. Looks like a fully functioning 36 megapixel camera. So it's going to rival your D4X. There is no such thing as a D4X. Did I just say D4X? D3X. Who knows? But it feels interesting. It's a first generation of something. So we'll see how it works. I don't even know if I can take... Nope, I can't take the lens off to see what it's like. But it's small, it's powerful, it has a lot of dedicated buttons on the outside, which is a good thing for a small camera. It just comes down to, how is this going to be? Why are we in live view? I want to get out of live view, get into the hybrid view. I can't find it. I don't know where it is. Oh, well. So there we have it. Oh, you just have to put your eye up against it. And then it goes ahead and makes the changes. Drop the shutter speed. Wow. The hybrid viewfinder is pretty cool. That is pretty cool. Yeah. Hybrid viewfinder is always a good thing. Can't wait to see when more companies put that in. But honestly, feels pretty good in the hands. We'll see what it is. Very expensive for what it offers, but it's a full frame sensor. And that's it. Jared Polin, FroKnowsPhoto.com. See ya. This is a Sony... 500 millimeter f4. This is insane, probably extremely expensive, but I want to try and zoom in. Well, not even zoom in, but I want to find some people and try to lip read if we can. Hi, what are you looking at?
Oh, I'm just looking at some Leica cameras.
Yes.
Are they nice?
Yes, they're really expensive.
So if you touch this button right here, it looks amazing. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah. Blah, blah. Looks good. How's it going? Oh, yes. Leica makes the best stuff in the world. Even though a Sony 500 F4 is looking at me. What'd you say? Excuse me? What? Yeah.
Ah, there's no mirror in this thing. Look at this thing. Wow, at least it's holding the focus. It's like a beat. It's like... Guy just winked at me. That's crazy. It actually held the focus really well. What do you look for in the tether tools booth? Well, it's the jerk stopper, and I think we found the jerk stopper right
Stop,
here.
Stop, you jerk!
Hey,
I'm the jerk stopper.
I'm not a jerk stopper, Mr. Arias.
No, you're the jerk that I'm stopping.
What are you stopping me from?
Being a jerk.
Do you have handcuffs?
I don't have handcuffs.
That are pink?
No, I do not have pink
handcuffs.
Do you want
to be handcuffed to me?
No.
You sure?
I'm pretty positive about that. Mm. I mean, we tried that once before in your loft in Philly.
It was just you and I late night. It was 2 a.m.
So how are you doing? What are you doing here?
I have this right
you
here.
You have your own.
I have my own. I'm
Garth
just
Brooks.
Garth Brooks.
You know.
The country music thing?
Yeah.
I'd rather be Avril Lavigne or something.
There you go.
Or Justin Bieber. What am I doing here? I'm just going around having fun, not talking to any tech reps, because all they want to do is tell you about their product, and I don't really want to hear it.
Right.
I just want to just tell me what it does real quick and let me figure it out.
Right.
What are you doing here?
Same kind of thing, walking around, like trying not to have a bad case of gas, you know, gear acquisition syndrome, and just meet people and seeing old friends and...
That's the fun of it.
Yeah.
Just walking around and being stopped and talking to people. And are you talking over at the booth this year?
I am pirating booths this year.
You're just doing whatever you want.
I'm doing whatever I want. I'm going in and I'm just taking over booths. And I'm tweeting, hey, I'm taking over this booth. I'll be there for 30 minutes. And then I just take over and then I leave.
So it's a takeover?
Yes.
You're the jerk stopper.
I am the jerk stopper.
Anything else fun going on while you're here?
No, the best part are the parties and the cocktail hours that you get free drinks and free food. So this is the cheapest you can do New York.
Yeah.
You know, if you get on the right lists, then you can like eat and drink for free for a while.
I don't know these lists.
And it's pretty great. All you got to do is follow all these manufacturers on Twitter and find out what they're doing, and you put the pieces together and you find out, oh, there's going to be at the social bar tonight, a photo shelter thing.
Or I just walk past, you know, follow along with you.
Yeah.
Just grab on to Zach and be like,
Absolutely.
Where are you going, Zach?
Absolutely,
You
yeah.
going together? All right, man.
Well, we could be handcuffed.
We could be. I'm going to handcuff myself to somebody tonight.
Yeah.
That's
Saw
the fun
Gregory
of it.
Heisler's opening. I got to meet Mayor Bloomberg.
Oh, nice.
That was pretty awesome.
A billionaire.
Yes. Quite so. But Heisler's new book is out. It's amazing. And his show the other night was fantastic.
Cool.
So that's been the highlight so far.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right. Well, keep having fun walking around here. We'll keep walking around.
I got some jerks to go stop.
See ya.
Adios.
Candace is legal.
Yep.
Not age legal, but legal department of, well, yes, you are legal of age.
I'm legal of age.
You're like 18 or 19? 20? 4? 26?
Lower.
25?
Lower.
24?
Lower.
23?
22.
Didn't I taste 20? So Candace is 22, former volleyball player.
Yeah.
That means did you have to wear spandex?
I had to wear spandex.
What is with that? Is that like short shorts?
Makes you jump higher.
Does it really?
No.
Like PF flyers?
No, I think a pervert came up with it.
A pervert came up with
but
that?
But it's more fun to play in anyways.
Oh, is it?
It is.
But you wear knee pads?
Yeah, sometimes.
You have to wear knee pads when playing volleyball.
Yeah.
It is.
Pecking
so.
Knees.
You're legal?
I'm legal.
And that's what you do?
That's what I do.
Is that fun?
It's a lot of fun.
I think it's fun.
Get to catch the bad guys.
There could be a lot of bad guys. But I'm thinking, I just wish my strap was here. Why isn't my strap here?
Your strap is way too popular. It'd be off the wall already.
It is. It would be. Somebody would try to take it.
Are you sure? All of the pre-orders were sold out.
Pre-orders were sold out. And now we're just waiting on the new stock that should have been in today. And, yeah.
That wasn't my fault.
It wasn't her fault. It wasn't Candace's
like
fault, but maybe at some point it will be. But anyway, Candace, thanks for taking the time.
Yeah, thank
Did
you.
You. Do you like my pink handcuffs?
I love your pink handcuffs.
Do you want a handcuff to me? She does. She wants to do it. Do you really? We could do it. Or I could just... Well,
handcuff me to my booth.
Well, do I have the key? What if I lost the key?
Then bathroom breaks are going to be a little awkward.
Awesome. That means Candace and I are going to be spending a lot of time together if I lose the key. So anyway, I'm going to go get back in the closet. Where are all the rest of the booth babes this year? Is it just you?
I'm an employee, not a booth babe.
You're a booth babe. If you're in a booth, you're
Joe
a booth babe.
Booth babe.
I'm going to check the closet to see
check
if there's
the
any booth babes. Excuse me, guys. Excuse me. Excuse me. Excuse me. Hey, how's it going? Booth babes, are you in here? Yep. The booth babes are in here, Steven. They're getting changed. That's right. They're getting changed in there. the booth babes. Excuse me. All right, so that's it. I found some booth babes. I caught them in the midst of being changed. Sorry, I just interrupted something. I just interrupted you. I'm sorry.
What?
I'm sorry. I just interrupted people. All right, we're going to move on to the next thing. Candace, thank you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
Violetta. Like Violet.
Like Violet. Where are you from?
I'm from Poland.
Hi. How are you? Where's your body paint? So do you like standing here in body paint, being looked at by people?
Of course, always. That's my second year.
Really? What were you last year?
It's hard to explain. I was painted also in paint.
And what are you this year?
It looked like Statue of Liberty.
In pink?
Yes.
It's the pink Statue of Liberty, everybody. Anything else? So what are you doing? So we know you're just standing here looking pretty?
Yeah, for a unique photo booth.
There you go. Yes. We got the unique photo booth going. Can I get some pictures? How's this look? Should I take my shirt off?
Yeah.
Should I do? You want me to take my shirt off?
No. Now you have to get
no?
naked.
She said I... Sorry, what do I have to do?
Get naked.
Right now. Right here.
Right now, right here.
Are you sure?
And then everybody else.
She feels lonely. Should I get naked? All right, Violet.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Nice to meeting you.
Nice to meeting you too.
I don't even know your name.
I'm Jared, aka the Fro is what they call me. That's see all these people looking. They're afraid to come up and talk.
I know.
But you want them to talk, right?
Not really.
Not really. So this is not good.
No, it's good.
It's
I'll
good.
Be talking to
you. Okay. All right, we're going to move on.
Okay. Bye.
We got some crazy guy running around. Crazy guy. Think Tank booth. We hit this one up every single year, no matter where we are at. And I hear that this is their new design, bigger booth. You don't really care about that. You want to see the gear. We use all the Think Tank gear. I've got my Think Tank bag on right now. This is the Urban Disguise version 2. I travel with it because it's great for my laptop, great for my Hebrew Trinity and the D4 on there, which I didn't bring this time. But Steven, let's walk through the booth. This is the big, hey, how you doing? This is the big ass bag. This is the one that you could almost, you know what? I think we're gonna have to do it. I think we're gonna have to see how we do with, don't mind me. We're gonna do some chest presses. Yeah. How's that look? Good chest presses? This is their big bag. Now if it was loaded, it would be even better. Let's go, feel the, oh yeah, burning with Think Tank. This is what it's, oh boy. This is the photographer's workout, sponsored by Think Tank. This really hurts. You gotta keep those abs tight. You keep them tight and you get really good. So there you have that. That's the big bag. It's like $600. I could buy a whole gym setup for that one. All right, moving through this way. More of the roller bags. I don't know what bags are over there. We've got more accessories hanging on the wall. I guess we'll turn this way. There's not much room. Oh, I'm going to spin you in a circle, Steven. We're going to go this way. One of my favorite bags of the airport rollers. This is the, I don't even know which one they call it. What do they call it? Airport Navigator. Yeah. So this, I always thought that this would be not very comfortable as a shoulder bag. The funny thing is, it actually is. This goes right into your hip and hugs it, and it feels comfortable. If you ever need to grab and go and take this, I love traveling with this one. I can fly with this one and my Urban Disguise 35. Those are two bags that I'll take with me whenever I go anywhere because I can put the laptop in here. I can put my clothes in here because I only wear one pair of jeans and multiple t-shirts. You know how it works. So we have that. Oh, and here's the rain cover. Look at that. This is what I used back in the day in the shower. I used this and it worked very, very well. What else do we have? Let's go back over to this wall. Yo. Let's see. I don't know what wall this is. This is a wall of...
This is my second brain.
My second brain, so we're being told. I don't know what that means, but maybe it's because your computer is your other brain, I think, right? You have... Oh, yes. Look at this. This is a dummy iPhone 5.
Yeah.
It's so nice. Oh, that feels... Oof. Oof. Oh, and oh my God. It's like a feather. Is this an iPad Lite Air? Whatever the heck they're calling it? No? But these are pretty interesting. A what?
Is that a dummy?
It is a dummy.
Yeah.
It's a fake one that is not real. But we have these second brains, iPhone, portable, good to carry around. I actually like carrying these things around. And I don't know. Let's see if there's something on the other side, Stephen. This is the mind shift side. If you guys remember, last year we did the mind shift bag. They had one bag, and it raised a ton of money on Kickstarter, and it did very well. They're in conjunction with Think Tank, so they've created another amazing set of bags for people that are traveling and outdoorsy types. They're pretty darn amazing. Now, I guess these must be some new stuff from Mind Shift. An interesting color blue with a little bit of navy. This isn't quite purple. This is navy. With nice orange highlights, really nice, right there. It smells like the Amazon jungle, and it looks like it, but it doesn't. So really, Steven, that's it from the Think Tank booth, guys. Let's move on to the next one.
Why does it have to be flesh colored? And why isn't your flesh that color?
You get
No. Answer the question.
Why isn't what flesh what
color? Why have you got to have a wireless? Why? What's it about?
So I can walk around and be comfortable all day, like you and in your spandex.
Just tap me on the penis.
In the No. Well, why are you wearing spandex if you don't want people to touch you?
No, because this is how I look good. This is how I roll, Jared.
This is how you normally do it?
Yeah.
You want to talk into the mic?
Are you not hearing me when I'm... He's not responding. I don't know if he can hear me or not.
Why are we handcuffed together?
I don't know. You just walked over, and if we haven't got a key for this...
Steven, did you bring the key?
I am pinkly handcuffed.
Yeah, and why are they pink?
You know, for more fun. Danny likes pink.
It is true. It naturally enhances my skin tones.
And what skin tones would that be?
Unlike the microphone you've got on.
This?
The flesh-colored nonsense, yeah.
Why is it nonsense?
I don't know. It should be black. Like, it's like gay Terminator.
What's gay Terminator?
Am I allowed to say that?
You can say whatever you want. Yeah. Now, last time I told you that, it didn't go too well.
You got in a lot of trouble.
I didn't get in that much trouble.
Anyway.
How you doing?
Am I about to get...
Love your hair. Ooh, what are you called? Are you a rocker of some sort?
No, you listen, right? You need to go and see our new videos.
I haven't seen any of your videos.
So we do these normal, like, our videos we try and do, like, quite normally.
Saw something in you in a hot tub.
Yeah, that's it. Okay, dressed like this.
Oh, all right. Well, I love your spandex.
Watch the videos, right? Because, like, how you want everyone... Just stop touching me. You can't afford it.
I can't afford
it. You can't afford it. No, not yet. Jared? Seriously? Use your teeth. That's fine. No hands. No. Because you know that's the lasting image that people have of PPE. Jared Polin nibbling on the flesh of another man.
The bell's end?
And the bell's end.
All right, I've had enough of this.
Yeah, me too.
Give me the key. You didn't bring the key, did you? I think I have a key.
Did you stand outside schools doing that?
What?
Nothing. What's with all these?
I shoot raw.
Does it really matter what you shoot?
Yes.
It does to Jared.
No.
I shoot JPEG just to annoy him.
Do you?
No. Of course I don't know. Shoot raw.
How does this thing work?
I don't know.
How does this thing work?
Okay, that works.
See ya. I think we found the best booth so far. It says, "For a child's smile." And I almost broke it. So they're sock puppets. I don't know what they do. I think they go on top of your camera to make a kid smile. But I'm more like... Oh, here we go. There's a fireman. Oh, whoa. Oh, I forgot to move my mouth. I'm going to interview this guy, but he doesn't have a microphone. I'm left-handed, so I'm going to do it there. I'm better with my left hand, if you haven't heard that. Hello, little kids. Are you going to smile so I can take your picture? Hello? Is there a fire in here? No. No? Nice mustache. Thank you. He's got like a porn stash going for children. It's like, bow, chicken, wow, wow, big chicken. Let's see what's underneath here. That's right. Nothing. All right. Who else can we talk like?
Yeah.
So we got that. Oh, no. Can I hold Elmo?
Yeah.
But Does it move? Does it? Hold on. Hold on. Look who's here.
It's Elmo. Hi, Jared.
What's up, Elmo?
Nothing. I'm going to make some kids smile today.
Huh?
Elmo. Hi.
Who can Elmo talk to? It's like,
hello, Santa Claus. How are you?
I wish there was an Eric Cartman one of these. Thanks for crossing. It's all right. If there was an Eric Cartman one, it'd be like, wait, hold on. Here's Elmo.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. There's Oscar the Grouch, but I want Eric Cartman.
Screw you, little kid. Smile. Smile.
You know, and be like, you know, stuff like that. Anyway, so that's it. That's from the Make the Kids Smile booth. I hope we made some kids smile today with some sock puppet love. And there you have it. You don't like... You don't like... This is yellow.
Not with the orange. You need
what about burnt sienna?
No, you need something that's got, like,
I need blue? Well, actually, oh, here we go. How about this? That is genuine leather.
That makes me hot.
Does it make you hot? Wait, hold on. This is how you do it. How's this? Is it this angle or is this one better? That? What about this? Look at this. This is beautiful. This is blue. This is like turquoise. But what else could we go with? This goes here. There's hot pink. Oh, there's the gold. I think that's gold. These are camera bags. They are not just purses. They are camera bags. They're soft and nice, and it's called... what is it called? How do I say that?
What's that?
Epiphany. Got it. Epiphany with an exclamation point in there. If you want to check them out, ladies, for all the Fro lady readers out there, Epiphany. Which one will you choose? Fruit. Look, it's not even real. So we have a world premiere here. I am very excited to introduce to you the Mac Pro. Let's go ahead and interview it. Hello, Mac Pro. How are you? Yeah. Hike. Steven, is this my best angle? Bill! Did you get it? Jaleel, get your roll in here, Jaleel. This is a rolling pimp.
What? What's good?
He's so rolling and he's a pimp. Take the football and go to town. Let's go.
Oh shit.
Take the football. Let's take you to the house.
What's up, Steve?
How do you catch a bandit with no legs?
You roll him over.
You roll him over. Okay, Jaleel. Here, I'm gonna snap it to you.
Alright.
I'm gonna give you the best angle. You ready?
Alright. Here we go.
Jaleel, how's it look? Jaleel, is it good?
Oh, I can see your undies.
Do you like it?
Oh.
There you go. Oh, Jaleel. Right here, Jaleel. Alright. Victory! You can't even see me. I'm not here. Bill, just walk over. Don't worry about me. I'm good. Bill, you want to step on my back?